Hello friends, welcome to Infinite Coaching Classes. Today we are going to discuss poem 1, The Clouds. So let's see. Here is a list of natural features mentioned in the poem. Against each write a line from the poem that shows its action or function. Cloud. I wear light shade for the leaves. Earth. The moist earth was laughing below. Thunder. It struggles and howls at its moon. Lights glimmering over my flea-like floor. Stars. The stars peep behind her and peer. Sun. The spear fire above its soft colors glow. Mountains. The mountains its columns be. Sky. I am the nursling of the sky. Answer the questions given below in your own words. What is the pillow white of the cloud as it sleeps at night? Answer is, at the nights when the cloud sleeps in the arm of the wind, the snow-covered mountains and pine trees are its pillow white. Next question. Where is the thunder? What is it doing? Answer is, thunder is chained in a cave. There it is struggling to get free and howling loudly. This imagery is used by the poet to describe the loud sounds that thunder makes as if some powerful prisoner is struggling against its heavy chains. Next question. Who is the cloud's pilot? Describe its action. Answer is, lightning is the cloud's pilot. It is sitting upon the cloud and is guiding it over different places like hills, lakes, plains, seas, etc. while searching for its spirit genie that it loves. Next question. What does the poet mean by fleece like and floor? Explain both the terms. Answer is, the cloud forms a layer between the earth and the sky. The layer is white and looks like the soft fleece of a sheep. This layer of clouds appears like a floor over which the moon and the stars seem to walk. Next question. What happens when the beat of the orbit maiden's feet tear the cloud's tent? Answer is, when the beat of the orbit maiden's feet tears the cloud's tent, the stars peep from behind the moon through the gap. They spin like a swarm of bees and are reflected in the rivers, lakes, and seas. Their reflections look like sky as if strips of sky have fallen down. Next question. Why is the moist earth laughing? Refer to the first stanza and find out who else is grateful for the same reason. Answer is, the moist earth is laughing because the cloud is dissolving the rain which will bring new life on earth and end a respite from heat. The thirsting flowers and new birds are also grateful to the cloud for this reason. Next question. Which natural phenomena is the cloud referring to when he says? Answer is, the natural phenomena referred too by the I bring fresh showers. The Dutch teams. Answer is cloud formation. Next, the triple arc. Dot colors warm. Answer is creation of a rainbow. Next question.
What is meant by I change but I cannot die? Why can't the cloud die? Answer is I change but I cannot die means that while the cloud changes its many forms, it cannot ever die. When the cloud dissolves, it becomes rain and it absorbed by the earth, rivers, seas, etc. Later, water vapors rise from these and form the cloud again. And so it continues forever. Next question. Read the lines given below and answer the question that follows. I bring fresh showers for the thirsting flowers. Who does I refer to in the above line? What figure of speech has been used by the poet? Answer is I in the given line refer to the cloud. The figure of speech that is used here is personification, as the cloud is the narrator here. And the entire poem is from its preservative perspective. Where does it get the showers from? The cloud gets the showers from water bodies like different seas and streams. It is from these water bodies that the water vapors to form clouds. What does it do for the leaves? Answer is, the cloud provides shade to the leaves in the noontime by blocking the harsh sunlight. Next question. Sunbeam proof, I hang like a roof. Where does the cloud hang from? Who helps it hang? Answer is, the cloud hangs from cap to cap. This means that the clouds were so dense that they covered all of the sky and seemed to spread from one mountain top to another mountain top. What is its shape when it hangs? The cloud looks like a very big roof that is spread over the sky and is held up by the mountains, which are its columns. Explain the meaning of the above line. In the above line, the cloud compares itself to a roof which is held up by mountains. Like a roof, the cloud is so thick and solid that it does not allow any sunlight to get in, so it calls itself sunbeam proof. Next question. I silently laugh at my own. What is the cenotaph? What is the cenotaph of the clouds? Answer is, the blue dome of air that is built by the winds and the convex gleams of the sunbeams when the sky is clear after the end of heavy rain is the cenotaph of the cloud. Why does the cloud laugh at its own cenotaph? The cloud laughs at its own cenotaph because the cloud knows that its depth is not permanent. It slightly laughs at the temporary peace that has been bought by its death, and it waits till it can undo that peace once more. What does the cloud do to its cenotaph at the end? The cloud destroys its cenotaph at the end as it is reborn. It then again creates all the coach and activity that is caused before. It compares this action to the birth of a child and rising of the end of the dead in their spirit form from their graves, just like the womb is for a child and the tomb is for a ghost. Thus, Neopetra is not a permanent resting place for the cloud. Next question. Look at the similes given below and explain them in your own words. And glides glimmering over my flea-like floor. Answer is, here the surface of the cloud in the sky is compared to a floor made of flea, as the layer of cloud is thick and appears as soft as flea. Next question. Like strips of the sky fallen through me on high are each paved with the moon and this. Answer is, when the clouds part off a little, the stars seems through the parting are reflected in the water bodies below. This reflection is compared to strips of sky which have fallen on the ground. Next question. From cap to cap with a bridge-like shape. Answer is, when the clouds spread in the sky, they appear like a bridge between two caps. Next question. Sunbeam proof, I hang like a roof. Answer is, the poet here describes the heavily clouded sky as a roof which does not let the rays of the sun pierce it. Next question. Like a child from the womb, like a ghost from the tomb. Answer is, here the formation of cloud is compared to the birth of a child and the rising of ghosts from their grave, powerful and inevitable. Next question. The streams slithered like a snake down the hills. Answer is, the movement of the streams down the hills is compared to slithering of a snake to emphasize on the twisting and turning path the streams takes as it flows. Next question. The two sisters were as alike as two peas in a pod. Answer is, here the similarity between the two sisters is described by comparing them to two peas from the same pod. Next, people ran away from the monster-like animals, fleeing a forest fire. The terror of people on beholding the monster is compared to the terror of animals caught in a forest fire. Next, the Seattle Express flung past her like a flying volcano. Answer is, the speed and clouds rumbling sounds that the Seattle Express made as it passed is compared to a volcanic eruption. Next, Sherlock Holmes looked as thoughtful as a chess player meditating his winning move. Answer is, Sherlock Holmes' thoughtful expression as he was trying to solve a case is compared to the expression on the face of a chess player meditating his winning move. Here the mystery of the game is also compared to a chess game solved move by move. That's all for this video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Thank you.